Channel 11 began beaming signals in 1953. At first, two TV stations shared that spot on the dial. WTCN broadcast from the Calhoun Beach Hotel in Minneapolis part of the day, and the rest of the time, people saw WMIN, with studios in the Ham Building in St. Paul. WTCN. In 1955, the two merged into one station. WTCN became part of the H.M. Bittner Group. By 1957, the station had been purchased by Time Life Broadcasting and had its first bona fide news team.
Mel Cash, Stuart A. Lindman, and Frank Butel with all the news from WTCN-TV's expanded news-gathering facility.
The weather maps were quite primitive by today's standards.
Well, hi, everybody. Three more high school basketball teams.
And the scores, rudimentary at best. But the station's real draw was entertainment for children.
Stay tuned now for Dave Lee. He'll be along with lots of fun and frolic and stuff.
With characters like Sergeant Scotty, Wrangler Steve, Captain 11, Merle and the Squirrel, and the biggest one of all,
Casey Jones Express, now arriving on track 11.
The legendary Roger Awesome, better known as Casey Jones.
And we were beating the other stations that were running news and weather and sports at that time. Shows you who was controlling the dial back in 1953-54. It was the children.
In those days, kids demanded very sophisticated humor. In 1965, Chris Craft Industries bought WTCN. While the world was changing quickly in the 60s, the technology used to capture those events lagged behind. The news was still shot and edited on film.
You've got about 20 seconds of wind, and then it runs out, and you have to rewind it. So you had to make sure that when you were shooting that you didn't start too soon and it would stop right in the middle of an important shot.
The 60s also brought professional baseball to Minnesota. And for years, fans could find the Twins on WTCN with play-by-play from Halsey Hall.
A pop-up down the right field line, and it may be in there.
A new decade, a new owner. Metro Media bought WTCN in 1971. In 1973, the company broke ground on new studios in Golden Valley with a bang. After 21 years, Channel 11 had a place of its own.
Boy, how'd you do this?
But it hadn't lost its colorful characters from the 1950s, like Chef Hank Meadows and all-around talent Mel Jack.
Here is the newest thing in tanning. It's called Cool Tan.
It wasn't all about making money. The station also reached out to the community with the annual MD Telethon and a weekly public affairs show, Concern, with veteran Stuart A. Lindeman.
All-Star Wrestling.
At other times, Channel 11 studios were filled with sweaty giants, legends in their own time. High school sports found a home here as well.
Score!
The daytime tradition continued with Warren Martin and Nancy Nelson's What's New. Meanwhile, in the newsroom,
live from Channel 11 in the Twin Cities,
the weather map still left much to be desired, but the talent wasn't bad.
But these have dissipated today and moved into Nevada.
On March 5th, 1979, a major milestone. WTCN joined the NBC network. Celebrities invaded the Crystal Court to welcome the newest member of the Peacock family, and the local news took on a fresh look.
News Center 11 boasts a staff of over 60 dedicated professionals, hand-picked from more than 2,000 applicants.
In 1983, the Gannett Corporation bought Channel 11 and reshuffled the talent deck. New faces with plenty of humor to spare.
I'm Paul Majors, but all the clothes I have on, it really doesn't matter. I could be anyone.
But we'll take your word for it. You're Paul Majors, and I'm Diana Pierce.
The Winter Carnival became an annual ritual, as did a live coverage of the Aquatennial, the State Fair, the Toys for Tots campaign, and a program devoted to recognizing volunteers.
Thank you, and good evening, and welcome to the first annual 11 Who Care Awards.
In 1985, the anchors began dancing to a new tune and a new set of call letters. By the mid-80s, NBC's primetime programming was also starting to show promise, more or less.
Robert Blake in his explosive return to TV.
God bless you.
Jury's still out on that one.
1986 brought yet another set of call letters.
K-A-R-E.
KARE TV spent the next decade building a strong national reputation in news. Over the next 17 years, KARE 11 created a lot of enduring images, as it became known for award-winning storytellers and photojournalists.
To move back?
Yeah.
Documentaries that gave us a closer look at the rich and famous.
Yes.
Highly acclaimed local shows like Whatever and Minnesota Bound. and unprecedented in-depth news coverage that captured everyday heroes like Jake Empey, a boy battling epilepsy.
Thousands are believed dead in the worst attack on America since Pearl Harbor.
And in the turbulent times of the new millennium, KARE 11 has remained front and center, at times right in the middle of the drama.
So there you have it. Two studios, three names, five owners, and countless faces. But KARE 11's persona has remained pretty much intact over the years, doing our best to reflect the communities we serve. For KARE 11 News, I'm John Croman.